Next. Sleep 2E. He calls it Road to Shatter 2K. I guess he's smurfing on this account. I don't know what his actual rank is.
Gaming's overrated.
Gaming is overrated. Thank you for the follow. Yes, we're already back. We're back. Oh, it's Sleep2i. Oh, he's actually in chat. He's in chat, guys. So what is your actual rank if this is a smurf? But 27.7 is your actual rank? Wait, so this isn't a smurf then? You're just... Yeah, I mean... No, see if you made a joke. He's like, huh, not much of a smirk, lol. I kid. No, you're fucking right. Like, if you're smurfing like 500 ranks down, like 500 SR down, like that's not really a smurf. Anyhow, how many reviews I'll do tonight? Let me look at the list. Fucking A. Fucking hell. Done this one. One's gonna be done. Done. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. At the time that I looked at Discord, and we got two more while this review was taking place. Man, I'm reviewing these really slow because I'm just like, I'm fucking off. You know what I'm saying? I'm doing a lot of stupid stuff. This happens. This happens, guys. I don't know. We'll see how many. You're out of here, Elemental Dragons. Peace. Let's say another couple hours. Because you asked about diving. Yeah, that did prolong stuff. We wasted like 10-15 minutes on the dive talk. You know what? I don't want to listen to this, so we're going to have some soft chip tune in the background. Is that the correct, let me just talk. Talking. How is... Oh, that's a little bit too loud. I was gonna say, how is the volume compared to my voice? That should be fine. Gold sim? Yeah, you can submit a review. You hate when people, you're a smurf or you're hacking because you get reported so often. That happens.
Ah,
alright.
Aiming's overrated.
So we have Papa! Hold on. Sleet UI. He is Genji. This is a smurf, ha ha ha, he's in gold. But he's actually a whopping 2700 rank. Not much of a smurf, but let's go with it. All right, this is rough. I got to turn that off. I need game sound. Man, my brain goes nuts when I can't hear noises in the game. That's how much I'm dependent on sound. When I don't hear them, it makes me like physically ill. So you find a Lucio right off the bat. You give him the old combo, get him killed. Proceed to have a ninja duel. Get him. Right into the combat. Good. All right. No, this is fine play so far. A lot of people use Smurf to mean alt account. That's true. That's, yeah, and there's nothing wrong with that. A Smurf always, like, has the undertone that, like, I'm going to a lower game to win and make fun of people kind of thing. It has that bad undertone to it. So this isn't a Smurf, it's an alt account. That sounds so much nicer. It's a cute little thing you did there. The dash through on the right side to get around him on the left. You did good. Your tracking seemed decent enough there. My ultimate is charging. Is it possible that my account will get banned with really loud research to make reports for truthful? Reporting does nothing in Overwatch right now. Ooh, damn, that juicy charge tank. But if you do get banned, it'll get banned in a wave. That's how Blizzard is banning. Alright, you made it. You live through the shatter. Sorry if you dodged the fight there. I mean, it's a little weird that you're not taking pot shots. Now you are. And I just want to bring up something really quick, because I did watch this video before. I noticed this a lot. You like the right click, and then you melee. So what happens is Genji's highest DPS ability is his secondary attack. So when you melee like that, it slows it down. If I remember the numbers correctly, your main attack is every 1 second or 0.9 seconds, I forget. Your secondary is 0.7 seconds. And your melee, if you try to, like, weave it in there, it just delays everything. So don't melee unless you have to. Definitely right-click. It does a lot of damage if it all three hit. This is good. And that's what you want to be doing is Genji. Genji's really good at duels. So it's good finding someone on the side of combat, or on the edge. Oh, the wombo! There you go, you're doing good. Yeah, just keep right-clicking that guy. You thought I was playing? Nope, this is not me. Look, see, I can fuck around. Oh. Not me. Why did I get pinned out on everybody? The old ninja duel. And you get hammered in the face. We did okay plays there. The best way to describe what Genji does, and you know, I may do it at the end of the review. A good way of thinking about Genji, I think about classes and verbs. Like, Mei is... I'll just talk about this really quickly. Like, I think Mei is to shave. Or not to shave, that's Genji. Mei is to freeze. So, like, her wall, when you're out of position, someone's, like, on the other side of the wall, she... You made this wrong decision, and she is freezing you, right? You have to make this bad decision for 5 more seconds. She also, like, literally freezes people. She stops. If we're looking at the triangle... What am I doing drawing the triangle? Is that a fucking triangle right here, boys? She literally freezes the logistics phase, right? She will stop a team with a wall from moving. She freezes people. You know, that's kind of her thing. Genji is to shave. And by shaving, I mean... if we consider combat these two lines, right? There's a Reinhardt with a shield, a Reinhardt with a shield. People usually have these types of, and this is the most common look at battle. And like people be spread out around here. Either they're behind the Reinhardt shield, some flankers are flanking, some people are doing some other stuff. That's it. Now what Genji does is he skates on the edge of combat. Right, he's close enough to the main fight that if he wants to get on it, he can get on it. And if someone's flanking, he can get on the flanker. But what you want to do is you want to shave. And what I mean by shave is very carefully... Oh, it's really hard to see that. I got green. You want to, like, anyone on these edges... Like, you want to pick off. This can... If someone's right here... This applies to. You want to just take someone out. So to cut or to shave is how I look at it. That's how I think of the class. You'll notice in the video here, Sleet will be in the middle of combat a lot. Well, he's not even the middle. He's here. If you watch Seagull or someone like extremely good, they're going to be around this area. They're going to be on the outskirts until it's time to find someone to pick off. Either they see someone get hurt, or they hurt someone themselves with the like Mouse 1 Shuriken, and then they go in for a kill. They can come in to save some allies for a little bit. You know, they can help stuff off. They can flank. If there's a flanker, they can help against that. He has good mobility, so that's what he does. Like I said, Genji, and this circle is just a shaved off square, right? But that's what I mean by shaving. To cut. That's what I think about when I think of Genji. Can I talk about what other classes are like that in the video? I guess we go over some other ones. And so I'll be bringing this up more. As soon as I said that, and if you think, look at, and you'll watch this play, you'll start seeing what I mean. Oh. Quick note. At least this is what I was checking beforehand. D.Va's mech is a projectile. You can deflect it and get her and cause her to take 50 damage. Because you just took 50 damage from that mech falling down. If she was below 50 health, you can kill her with it. So close. Need some good reflex there.
Bro, freaking Genji's ult lasts like 10 minutes, I swear.
See, there's that attack again. That melee, it doesn't seem like it matters, but you're really slowing down your deeps with that. Like, you could have attacked 2 or 3 times with your right click. Look at this guy. Elkhart. Deflect was on cooldown, so it didn't matter. Was it on cooldown? Is he being a very over-specific person? Hold on, we gotta find out if he's wrong. Isn't it funny, though, that people, like, try to nitpick that much? They're, but you're wrong, Crow. Let's check it. I wanna check it, just so we can shove it in the guy's face. I'll take that risk. I like gambling. It was way before this, wasn't it? Is it the fight before this? Where is it at? Is it right here? No. It was on cooldown 1 second. You sure? I remember seeing it. I swore I saw it and I was like, oh, it's on cooldown. Or it's off cooldown. But I like taking bets like that. I like putting it on the line. I'm cool looking like an idiot. If I have a chance to make someone else look dumb. That would show him, wouldn't it? That would show that fucker. You know what? I can't find it. Why can't I find it? We're gonna spend the whole review looking for that one fucking part, aren't we?
Why would you break it down? Him and...
This is it, isn't it? This is it! The D.Va ult's gonna come right here, right through your face. Three, two, oh, that was so close. You win this round, Mr. Smarty Pants. Oh, then it just ends. He tries to get there from spawn. It ends. I'm not going to concede defeat. No, that's when I bet more. I bet more. I could have ignored his comment. No one would have even thought twice of it. And I was like, you know what? No. Fuck this one guy in particular. I'll call your bluff.
Do you want to play Zarya?
He just deflected something else, but it doesn't... And here's the thing. It doesn't change the overall fact that, yes, you can deflect D.Va's mech. We don't even know if she was low enough health. I think she was at max health. She would have lived, even if he had deflect up. Yeah, there you go. Even if deflect was up, it still wouldn't have mattered. You do this a lot, and I know this is a Genji thing to do. Hold on. And I'm not saying this is wrong, I'm just saying, have a plan. So if you see the enemy's formation, and you dive through it, and get to the other side, make sure you've got something, because very easily like that you can die. Right, so you took 100 damage when you didn't need to, because you pressed forward when maybe you didn't need to. But that's all very, very situational based. I'm just saying it wasn't a bad move. It's just dive behind enemy lines when it suits you. Don't just dive behind enemy lines because that's what you believe is better or what to do. Good old double dash. Dash reset. So far, so good. I mean, you got the tracking down part. Yeah. I mean, you're definitely taking liberal use of how generous Genji's dash hitbox is. Good dash. So this is good. And this is what I mean by on the side of combat. Like, it's just barely on, like, the cusp of combat. Like, everything wants to happen through this choke point, and you're just kind of, like, right here, and you can go above this wall if you wanted to. Because look how nice, like, this is delicious. I mean, all these guys can do something against you, but this is, you know, you got 3 200 hit point classes in front of you. The back lines were exposed, and you get the old dash kill. Oh, the wombo. Zarya plus anything is amazing. All right. And I like you coming in here, like you're supporting your Reinhardt. Again, you committed super deep, but hey, it worked. That's the thing about Genji. Genji's positioning doesn't... It's not like all the other heroes in the game. Because most people, you want, like, very good positioning, very proper. You don't want to dive into the enemy too much. Like, you will with Winston. D.Va, you don't want to dive into the middle. You want to dive, like, on the edge of their formation.
My genius, he's finally
but Genji, because of his abilities, man, like, it changes so much depending on if you can get a kill or not or what else happens. It's a bit hectic. But the guidelines of shaving the edge of combat is what I would say is the biggest thing to know about Genji. Spy Microwave just subscribed. Spy! You working for the CIA? That's alright, my microwave doesn't get to see shit. It just looks at a wall. Can you deflect D.Va alt? No. Fuck no, that would be amazing. It would be such a big target for Genji to deflect. You'd be like, oh, I guess I'll just walk over here and deflect it right back at her. Oh, that Pharah. Get the wombo. Get the combo. Yeah, good. I mean, you have pretty good tracking. I like that. I don't see Genji do that enough where you dash and melee her. That takes 80 health away. And as a Junkrat player, 80 health is important. Right? She'll die to one mine, one grenade. So that 120 damage is within the realms of the game. Widow does 120 body shot. Hanzo does 125 body shot. Pharah does 120 rockets. Junkrat does 120 grenades. So doing 80 damage is really good. You get some really good dash resets. Like, your accuracy is spot on. Also, Elkertert, a really weird name. Elkertert, thank you so much for your subscription. Both you guys. You and this face. Forgot his name already. What's your face? Spire Microwave. How could I forget that name? Enjoy your emotes. You know, spam it up, boys. You earned it. I'm sorry, Ryan. For taking the bet earlier. See, guys? Fucking guys. This is what happened. I got a sub. Because I called that motherfucker out. I was like, you know what, you son of a bitch? You think you know better than me? Whose stream are you watching? Oh, yeah, my stream, not your stream. I was right, and then I went back, and I was wrong. You know what? Because that's why I like to bet big. You risk big, you win big. This time I lost big, but I also won big because the motherfucker subscribed. Well, thank you so much. Thanks for the sub, man. And more importantly, I was sticking up for something that gave me personality, right? Like, it's better than just being like, well, okay, I'll just maybe you were right, maybe I was wrong. Let's just go with it. I'm not a fucking boring guy like that. No! Bet at all! On green! I only got black and red. Green's not even an option. Actually, double zero and zero, but there's no green on the roulette table. So, team goes left. Oh, I wanted to mention this too. You deflect before something happens, which is okay, but when stuff is like this, at least get shot once before you deflect. And this is a little known fact, guys. You run faster forward than reverse. So Reinhardt will actually always catch up to you like that. But I want to look at this. What was your positioning before this? So I like this. This is what I mean by the edge of combat. So you're like right on the cusp of combat. And you're like, okay. And right here, that guy can be killed. And so you took that bet. And whether or not you got him or not, you forced him out of position with pressure, which is good. And so now this is when you turn your tail and run. No, it's alright if you mess up. Like, Lucio's speed boost, and that's why I think, that's why I don't do nitpicky thing. Like, oh, you should have saw the speed boost, blah, 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 blah. I'm not going to be that guy. I don't like nitpicky analysis. There's general overviews. Like, no matter what I say during the reviews, I may look a little nitpicky, but at the end is when I kind of try to bring it all together. And that's when I tell you the things that you need to do. I may point out X and Y here, but don't worry about it. Don't take it to heart. So there it is again. Maybe you deflected a little bit early. Just wait till you take... Or, you know, wait till someone's shooting at you or, you know, something's actually on your way. Now, here is what I like. That soldier, this threatening menace that you provided, you're like, oh, soldier's on the edge. This is exactly what I mean by the edge of combat. This is where Genji excels. Even if you pressured that soldier to kill him, would have been good. I was happy either way. But the fact that you didn't bother with him because something was closer here for you to deal damage to, which is great. That is, like, I like that awareness. There you go. You get 2 dashes, 3 dashes. So, I mean, I'd say that was, like, a superb play right there. I talked before. Sleet, were you here when I was talking about the monkey and how you catch a monkey? Yeah, Zarya's shields are the same thing. You're here about catching the monkey? Okay, so you know about holding on to something is your own tension. And when that soldier was going back here, like, most people would dive on that. Especially, you're not gold, you're platinum, but still. People do that at Master and Top 500. People see, like, they'll do, like, oh, I hit that soldier 3 times. I have to kill him now. And I really, like, I respect the fact that you let it go. You're just like, you know what? It's going to take him 3 seconds to run around there. Why don't I just attack in here? How to catch a monkey? Do we have to go over that? Genji excel at that because of his mobility or because of his ability to 1v1? Both. So yeah, like staying around the shades of combat, that right on the edge. So this point's an actual, like, oh my god, that's terrible. But yeah, like, it's like that but straighter. And then you have these walls here, right? And you have the walls here. So yeah, Genji really excels at around here. Also, you can flip in and out of the windows here. But anything on the edge of combat. Now, combat is going to be outside of here as well, so things differ. But if we're talking about the point specifically, like, he chased the soldier around this way, and then he's just like, you know what, fuck it, I'll just go in the middle of combat. Yeah, no, the way to actually catch a monkey, we'll just go over it very quickly. Aw, yeah, how to catch a monkey, motherfuckers. This is what you do. You take food, and you shove it in a hole. Also, first thing you do is show the monkey you're shoving food in the hole. So this guy's he's literally, there he is, like, it's a terrible infograph, but he's shoving food in the hole. So what happens? Nothing. He's just like, you know what? Fuck it, monkey. There's food in that hole. Go and get it. Go and get it, you son of a bitch. And so he just kind of is like, you know what? I'm hidden now. It's kind of like, Skyrim. It's like Morrowind, guys. He hit shift. Therefore, invisible. I can't see him. Where'd he go? Monkey's like, holy shit, that guy just fucking disappeared. But there's food in there. The guy's like, oh man. He's like, just one more level, guys. Just one more fucking level. I got such a high sneak level. Such a high sneak level. He's like, yeah. Go get that food, you stupid monkey. So, what happens? Monkey puts his hand in here. Again, here's the food. Now, he grabs the food, but because his fist is larger than his hand, right? Like, his hand can slide in here, but his fist is actually larger. So, his hand is now stuck. And this guy just walks over. Like, all right, monkey. Like, you could literally get out of this anytime you wanted. And he just puts a fucking rope on his neck. And you got a pet monkey.
Timing's overrated.
As soon as he grabs his hand, he essentially hits the muscles that will relax the fist. Yeah. But, so what this is talking about, besides how to catch a monkey, which is fucking hilarious, is that it is his own tension right here when he makes the fist that is causing him to essentially become a circus monkey. This is what's going to cost him his life. I use this analogy against Pharahs, because once a Pharah hits someone once, their own tension of saying, I have to kill this guy, I touched him once, is really applicable. So in this aspect, we will go back to where he saw the soldier. You thought I was going to tell you how to kill Winston? No, man. This is, like, legitimately how to catch a monkey. So at this point, he... Write this. He sees the soldier. First of all, the soldier's hacked and he hit him once. He hit him two more times. So he's at, what, 84 minus 100? Oh, he's pretty high health, actually. But it should have been 28 times 3 would have been his damage. But at this point, he could have let the tension of damaging the soldier get to him and commit on him. But he doesn't. He actually turns towards the point and deals with the immediate threats. So it's a little thing, but I will tell you 95% of players in Grandmaster and Top 500 would fall for that. They may have not fallen for this soldier specifically, but they will damage people and do whatever they can to kill him after that point. They allow their own tension to kill themselves. What I'm saying is Genji is a smart monkey. He's one smart monkey. He's a cyborg smart monkey. Well, technically he's a human, right? So it's smart monkey. That's what we are. This is funny. Alright, this is... You guys probably won't find the humor in this. But that was amazing. Wasn't that hilarious? Now, why do I find this so funny? I just want you guys to notice something. Remember when I talk about Pharahs being a flank? I'm like, if there's a Pharah Mercy up here, consider that a flank. And then attack the four people on this flank to kill them, right? Because these guys are taking time flanking so we can kill them. And I always say, well, flanking takes time. So if someone's running around, a circular line is longer than a straight line. So what you want to do is you want to take a straight line and kill the team that's not flanking, right? So if one guy's flanking, then you want to kill the five people here with your six people for a numbers advantage. Now, this is the extreme. Watch this. I just want everyone to see. Right here, that this dark shadowy figure is a Reaper. The entire team is here. I assure you this. Now, it's 1357. Watch this. It is 3 seconds later. Reaper is already here killing your team. Soldier killed two other people. Reaper killed one. And you got one. In the time it took you to quote-unquote flank above them, they speed boosted and rotated underneath you and killed your team by the time you hit the ground. Yeah. So we always talk about flanks as these really big, wide things. Like, oh, going over here, going through the building, coming out this way and getting someone. A flank can be as quick as Genji going up in the air, and by the time he hits the ground, you kill his team. There's nothing you can do about that. They just did really good things.
Alright, we have a Zarya ult, though. My EMP is charged. Your EMP for the Zarya ult.
I mean, it was a good play on their part. If nothing else, you shouldn't be like, man, what can we do to do something better to not have that happen? I like that deflect a lot better. That was... Ooh, you son of a bitch. You could have dashed out with that second dash, but you dashed in more. But it works. Ogwale, live a question. Sorry, I was looking at chat. Ogwale said, "How do you know that soldiers in the middle is a better choice than, or leaving the soldier to go to the middle is a better choice than going for the soldier? What's the main advantage? Why would you do that?" The other man in chat, Mr. Silver Saxophone, said, "Well, the soldier has to get on point. Also, as the soldier's leaving this way, soldier's strength is range." Right, that's what he's really good at. He's good at medium, long range, and dealing the deeps before you can even get to him. He's not going this way. Right, if he does, he's going to have to go this way to fake you out, and then go this way, and that flank takes too long. We just talked about how flanking takes time. And the flank that this man himself went up to come down to lose his entire team, if that's slow, then going all of this way just to go all of this way is incredibly slow. Best case scenario, he'd run this way and shoot you from the hallway or get on point. If he was like a crafty son of a bitch and he saw his team die, like he could have rocket jumped over that. Either way, the point is the point of the game. So do that. That's your best bet. And this is a... This is... Okay, I'm glad you die here. Why I say I'm glad you die here is that... like I say, Genji shaves around combat. Like, you want to be around the edges, and if you see weakness, you get it. You just kind of dove in the middle there, and I've been waiting. Dude, I've been just waiting. I'm like, you know what? You're going to get your ass kicked. One of these times, they're not going to push in as far as you think, and the whole team's just going to sit back. And after you dash, you're going to be in the middle of six mans with a deflect. And, yeah, that's what happens. Yeah, greedy and tried for alt charge. Oh, you son of a bitch. Look, Genji has no falloff damage, so just sit back. You know, deal some deeps that way. That was a good deflect there. I like that one. Look at that Lucio. Man, these fucking DPS stankies wanna be. DSP stanky, I should say. So, I mean, you're good with that, man. You're good with the Dragon Blade. And I know a lot of people want to be like, well, he's only good when he's nano boosted with a Dragon Blade. It's like, I don't care. He's still fucking good with it. My ultimate is almost ready. You do it again. Now, I'm not sure how much I agree with this decision. At least poke your head out for you to deflect for 2 seconds. If nothing else, your team doesn't get shot for 2 seconds by Soldier Alt. And you could also do poke damage to get alt percentage up. I like that move right there. That's a Genji thing to do. I think you get saved by that Zarya ult. I think this was a really greedy move he did. And here's the greedy part about it. I don't mind this dash in, but there's still a soldier in front of you. And you turn around. I know you want to kill the weak target, but now you put a soldier at your back. Where you can easily get killed. But the Zarya pulls him in and he doesn't hit you at all. Actually, he does hit you. And he did over 100 damage to you. So that was close. This is the fourth review, yes.
The fourth review!
Hmm. Let's skip. We can save some seconds. Oh, they got a Junkrat. You're shit out of luck now, man. I know a couple of Junkrat players and they're really good. Mm. Oh! Oh, you almost got your bluff called. This is... I almost thought you... Oh, man, if you had a dash, you could have killed... Man, this is a Genji's wet dream. You get the Mercy. If you had the dash at this point, you could have killed the Reinhardt, which would have lowered Junkrat below another dash, and you could have dashed him to death and then killed the Winston. Like, it would have been awesome. You would have been a fucking hero. It didn't happen, though. I mean, it was still a good play by you. I like this part because I think you knew the Winston was hurt, and that's, or not the Winston, the Reinhardt, and that's why you went for him. So very good pick on that one. And use the pick reset for the dash to get out. That wasn't my phone. That was some guy's phone in the game. Hey, here's another one of those deflects. I know it's a small point, but it's like, wait a half second. You and your Sombra get a good kill there. Oh! You found a Junkrat. Dangerous going right for the Winston, but... It kind of worked. You managed to stay alive. And then no deflect just gets you killed. Genji definitely revolves around very minute timings. If you're in the wrong spot without deflect, you just die. That's just the nature of the class. He's kind of a glass cannon. He is a glass cannon, that kind of. Lucio drops the beat. Oh man, if you had a dash, that'd be so great. Pow, you get one. And then he types. Oh man, don't even type. It's a waste of your time. Your eyes got too big, man. You saw the entire team together. You're like, I need to ult now. Alright, you see the mine and trap right next to you? Oh, man. If that Junkrat was smart, he would have detonated that mine to knock you off. You would have stayed up, but it would have been a better fight than just dying like that. Yeah, there you go. There you go, that's great. Getting behind Reinhardt's shield like that. You're waiting for the team to regroup at the spawn area. Nice. Okay. My ultimate is charging. Alright, we're getting close. Alright, regroup. Junkrat bombs coming from right. Careful. Yep. You jump around and throw shuriken. This is Genji 101, man. You suffer no falloff damage. Remember that. Oh, what a... That was good. You damage the Mercy enough and you force her out of hiding, which calls her to die. Yeah, and you got it. You know it. It's OT. You got Dragon Blade. Well, you got stunned. Get out there with that deflect. Man, they just won't lose peacefully, will they? There you go. And you win it! Yay! Do you play the game? I probably could have just waited, right? Oh no, Reinhardt does right here. During the wombo combo, he misses everyone somehow with the charge, but then he just hammers the shit out of everyone.
Fuck you, you wouldn't have gotten that if I didn't need him.
Yeah, that grab is juicy.
47 objective kills. You killed 47 people on point. That's pretty good. Pretty good. So... to the triangle. Action. Everyone can tell that your skill with them is pretty good. The only thing to talk about would be the deflect timings. Also, you only did this on the first point, and I don't know if it's because there was a D.Va or what. How much you meleeed instead of right-clicking. Just remember right-clicking slows things down. I think you do it a couple times when you're reloading and you catch yourself and you force yourself to reload like 1.25 seconds twice in a row. Most classes are 1.5 second reload time. Melee interrupts that and it forces you to reload again. So if you spend a second reloading melee and you have to spend another second and a half. So just watch your melee. Position, I guess we briefly talked about that. Why? No. Fuck. How do I draw a goddamn shape? That's text. I don't know. Don't worry about it. Let's get rid of red. We'll go to blue. So we talked about Genji and in relations to position. Hold on. To shave is what I see Genji as, to cut. So your main job is to sit, essentially, it's like a circle within a square. The square is combat. You want to be around like on this edge. And what you want to do is you want to be close enough to battle that you can get your shots in easily. And anytime you see a weak person or someone out of position, you'll kill them. So if a weak person in here, there's someone flanking. But you rather like avoid the main guys, like the big guys in the middle, unless you have to get them. Unless for whatever reason you find them, you know, necessary to attack. Yeah. You do this a couple times. We talked about it with the soldier. They didn't really flank at all. In my head. I can't remember any flanks. So yeah, you didn't have to worry about flankers this game. but most of the time you're spending most of your effort within this circle. Now, when the brawl happens, so like when the shield goes down and people are just fighting on the point and everything's going everywhere, right? So when like there's a yellow person in here and there's a blue person in here and everyone's fighting everyone, then it's okay to be inside of this circle. And going after whoever you feel is the best target at the time. But even then, when all this stuff is going on in the circle, you probably want to look at the back lines and kill the squishies. Unless something particularly stands out, then I would go for them. Logistics. The logistics again, decision making and actual movement. Movement in relation to get to a better position. Just because you valued being in the fray more, your movements were very linear and to the point. Which is good, except for Genji, you want to be on a little rotation around it. Right? You don't want to have the straightest movement. It's cool when you do, but when engaging the enemy, like, it's cool if you go straight to get up to this point, but then try to get on the outskirts of combat, right? It's cool if you get here straight, but then, you know, flank a little. I wouldn't even say flank, just, you have to get to where you're unseen, and that's usually, like, right here, if we're comparing yourself to the blue team. But your decision-making was spot on. Yeah. I can't think of, like, one alt that wasn't that good. I know you're gonna think the last one where you alted when everyone was, like, pretty much dead. But you didn't know that. And, you know, your eyes get big. People tend to do stuff when, you know, something amazing shows themselves like that. You're only human, right? You can't... That's quite the, what would they call it? Desire to kill everyone, like, it's amazing. Hey Crow, I play Winston a lot, but who should I learn when I play good and they bring out Bastion Reapers and Roadhogs? Have I ever done a Somber review before? No, but I could. I mean, here's the thing. I would consider, like, a lot of class-specific skills up here, which I don't value that much. So I can critique any class based on this, because this is what I specialize in. Like, in Dota and Quake, everything I do is information logistics position. The actual action, what everyone says, everyone thinks, like, this is the most important thing, which is it's a different perspective, and I don't agree with it, but they can be right. Like, I mean, there's nothing wrong with saying being able to point and click is the most important thing. But I don't see that way. So it's not if I can review a Sombra play, it's if you as a person want to hear my critique on it from a positional standpoint. Which I would say Sombra is nearly completely all positional based. And with Winston, like, I'd have to see the review. I'd have to do it myself. I'd have to look at it. But what you're asking me is, how do you play Winston when there's counters in play? And you can play Winston still, it's just difficult. It's like how Junkrat plays still, but when there's counters in play, you gotta do specific shit. So yeah, your logistics, your decision-making was fine, and your actual movement was quite fine. A little detailed, but I'm nitpicking in your 2700 rank, so like don't even worry about it. I said nothing. Information, good thing about Genji, you're always interacting with the enemy, so therefore you have good, that's not a G, you have good info. Because you're always engaging with the enemy, you're always putting pressure, so you can see, especially when you're like when you're around here or here, when you're on the side flanks, you can get good information from the enemy. And for you personally, I think most of the time you made Like, you knew what was happening, you knew where your team was. And, like, when you did make poor decisions, like when you dash and you got caught, or a couple other times you dash in and you get caught, I don't think that was based on bad information.
Whoop.
I think you knew what you were doing, and you were just trying to get away with it. You had good information, but just made a risky calculation, or a risky choice, right? Because if you did come out alive there and you did kill a couple people, it would have been, like, amazing, right? You would have killed the push immediately. So risk big, win big. But you risk big, you can just lose, right? And since you're in chat, do you have any other questions? Right, you're in chat. Sleep. Will I be stuck in plat if I keep playing like this? No. No, I don't think so. I mean, you play well. Your fundamentals are there. I don't think you'd get stuck in plat. Is that what you're experiencing right now? That's what you're experiencing right now. So what I would tell you is get me a video where you don't win. I want to see a plat video of you losing. Mostly 4 DPS every game. That happens. But you have to play around it, right? You can't control other people's actions. I don't see any terrible habits that would get you killed as you get higher rank in this. You make some poor decisions, but they're greedy decisions, and I think I'm hoping you as a person will you will see them. Like, I think you've known where you were greedy in this video and how it was a stupid choice. But I didn't see any terrible decisions that you made that I see, like, if you were playing against the hero, or you're playing against the player instead of the hero, I didn't see you take too many of those. Like I said, but I mean, you kind of did when you dove in and you're like, I'll live through this. And then you didn't. I actually took notes on this. So from my notes specifically, my first point is wait a little bit for deflect. 2, watch your melee strikes. You use it a bit too often and make reloading take longer. Use it between secondary attacks to increase the cooldown on those. Careful when starting with dash. If you engage a situation with dash, it's not bad, you just need to have a plan. Just be wary of it. As for the triangle action, accuracy seems good. Watch your melee strikes that slow down reloading secondary attacks. Positioning. Sometimes you lack a backout plan after you get to where you want to be. Don't be afraid of surviving longer and taking pot shots on targets from where you're at. And that's what I mean by the edges of combat. Right? When you're shooting into the edge of combat, taking pot shots like that. You don't have to be in melee range 100% of the time.
Timing's overrated.
Watch the logistics. Watch the dashes in. Again, you want to hold right on the outskirts of mid-range and then shave off targets. Information. You seem like you know what you're doing during the game at most point of the times. A couple times you're in the middle of the fight, but you should figure out a target and see if you can take them out and then back out if you're not able to. So, yeah, I mean, my notes are pretty much exactly what I said. Would you review a game while watching someone stream? I don't like to do that. What do I do if DPS doesn't hit the enemy? Nothing you can do. Those are, I know those questions come from time to time. They're like, what if my healer is not healing? I'm like, well, you're fucked, right? Like, you can't control everyone's actions. Some people just can't play Overwatch. What I've always said is take away... I said this in the patch review. People can play Overwatch well. It's the pressure that gets applied on them from the enemy team when they start freaking out. So take away the pressure. So if you play Genji, kill the other people that are causing problems for your supports or for your DPS. Because your DPS are probably good at DPS. They just can't do it when getting pressured. You're bad at hit scan. It happens. You'll get better. I mean, not playing it isn't going to get you better at it. How do you deal with the Winston when you play soldier if he's zoning you? From the professional streams I have seen, like in professional games, Apex and whatever the fucking other tournament is, can't remember. A lot of the time, the soldiers will back up because Winston's will. A lot of the times, they get a bubble. You can heal. You can't heal out of Winston's Tesla gun. It'll still do slight damage to you. What I've seen a lot of people do is they retreat for a little bit, and they will pull the Winston out of the bubble. Excuse me. And you know, disengaging from him is the big thing. A lot of people disengage from him, and it kind of like nullifies where the bubble is at. The problem is if your positioning is in the middle of combat, like around your team, your Winston's doing a lot more damage and is being a lot more useful. Now, if you're on the high ground on a flank or something, and the Winston jumps up there and bubbles, now the bubble's useless because it's only protecting him on the top flank, like with you. So you can just run away, and essentially it wastes the bubble and his time. And then you can just sprint back into combat. Because once he has his bubble off cooldown and you're fine, then the fight becomes a lot more even. My genius is finally recognized. We got a new sub! Whoa! That's the wrong thing to tab to. Wombat94. Thank you, Mr. Wombat. Thanks for the sub, man. I don't even know who you are. I haven't seen you talk, but feel free to talk if you want. Ask questions. If you don't, then just thanks, man. Thanks for supporting me. Thanks for being around. Storm Smasher, technically, I don't use my wrist to aim. I just use fingers. If you covered my rank, what rank would you think I am? I have no idea who the hell you are. Oh, Sleet? Sorry, I just looked up and saw the name. Are you telling me to guess your rank? Would you be able to give more heroes their verbs? Oh, the verb thing. Man, I haven't thought all of them through. I need a hero list. Wop, wop, wop. Yeah, Hanzo, what was it for Hanzo? I mean, Hanzo, I almost think to pick. Hanzo's big thing, obviously it's range, but he's good at killing 200 hit point class. He has a rough time with other classes. He's like a burst. He's kind of like Junkrat with, he's bursty, but his burst isn't the best. It has longer range, but it's still not like a Widow type guy. Widow is linear. When I think of her, I just think very straight lines. How do I stop my Steam from doing stupid? You can't. As soon as you said, how do I stop my team? The answer is you can't. What would I say Sombras is? Oh my god. I had the word on the tip of my tongue. It's like a combination of disarray and enabling. I don't know how to, I would have to actually like be an English person or English student to actually like know of a verb like that. Sneaky? No, it's not sneaky. She's not. Sneaky implies a lot of other things. Facilitating? Yeah, it's something. Disputing? No. You thought I had all the answers? Yeah, there's no way I can tell you how to fix your teammate from doing something stupid. In fact, the only thing you can do is go with them on it and do stupid stuff with them. That's probably your best option. Disrupting, yeah, that's what I want to say, but...
Timing's overrated.
Yeah, it disrupting, but... There's a better word out there. I'd have to really think about all of them. I did this for a lot for Dota characters, and like I have a couple in my head for Overwatch, but I'd have to actually like sit and think down about them. But yeah, I mean, I can do that. I can come up with that stuff. Thanks to the review crew. One last question: will you upload this on YouTube? Oh yeah, I got it. When will the next review stream be? So if I've reviewed you before, I want to at least waste 2 weeks on you specifically. I want you to try and get better and then apply that and see what happens. When the next review stream will be, I don't know. It'll just take me. I just do it randomly. So yeah.